not recognize the players from here. So we will see it in a hot minute, but that means
I think
bracket will progress, my guy. Oh, okay, we got Ryze and Naka.
Yes, oh, okay. So no worries here.
Okay, Ryze, I mean, obviously being a guy from Austria, if I assume it, correct me if I'm wrong, of course, being one of the stronger ZSSs. Him and Suba are the ones who kind of set up the pace when it comes to ZSS meta, at least in this context.
Yeah, and Naka, on the other hand, is giving us the look at Palutena.
Yeah, yeah, a German player from Bavaria, to be exact.
Tell me more.
Yeah, yeah, so he played Fox before, but in this game it is mostly Palutena, and so far he's sticking with the guns. Actually, I really like seeing this matchup after a while, honestly.
Yeah, and this is pretty interesting and aggressive for now. We are going on Smash Bros, so we are looking for interactions, physical interactions between the players.
Sir.
And for now, the control of the game is on the side of Ryze, being a lot aggressive with his ZSS and managing to find the control of the terrain. Obviously, when I'm saying that, Naka is getting into a good phase and trading again.
Yeah, and just abusing the sheer speed that ZSS can provide you. And now, not only with the kick flip, of course, getting punished by Naka Dog. Naka, on the other hand, having a rather fast character with Palutena as well. Not really on the spotlight as much as before, since, you know, it is boring to play for some guys, but she is still pretty strong. But if can Naka prove it against Ryze, we will see.
Yeah, and there's not a lot of mistakes from both sides. And you say that, again, Ryze was abusing of his speed and his movements. On the other hand, we have Naka abusing his shield with the dash attack and the back air that are invulnerable and making him able to rush in and deal some damage. And you already seen the pressure he's applying on the shield of Ryze. And yeah, again, okay.
Ooh.
This is
this is gonna kill you.
As I say, there were a lot, not that much mistakes from both sides, but when they happened, they were finished accordingly every time. So this is really good. And for now, Naka is taking the lead.
Mm-hmm. And I really like how we're clearly seeing a testing waters type of game, but in a very fast pace, because you do not want to give up the pace in favor for the other, since both Palutena and ZSS can. Now, speak of punish game, clearly abuse you on this stage.
Yeah, and for example, I'm going to talk about what they call in France the Palutena attacks, which is when you're at 0%, the string of nurse she gave you to up to like 40, 50%. So yeah, this, I'm kind of expecting this, not now, because obviously we're already at 50%, so it doesn't work anymore. But yeah, for now, Naka is in the control of the game. We're going to see what happens now. Okay, an explosive him here. Yep. Why not?
Using it only solely for disadvantage, which I kind of like, since, you know, compared to Czech, of course, they are using it for different matters. Czech does like to use it to force out air dodges, force out frame traps, but Naka wants to keep it a bit more safe here.
Yeah, for now, Naka did manage to catch something, like he did manage to read the roll in, but didn't manage to punish it, which is a shame, because he could have gotten the stock early here, and he would have loved it. Otherwise, okay,
ooh,
good parry here,
dash smash here. Wow.
That's quite interesting. I did not
expect it. It is quite brave as well, because,
whoa!
A bit swingy, you know.
Ryze is being exotic here on his recoveries, and I love it, let's be honest.
Sure.
Okay.
It did help him out in surviving so far.
Yeah, but for now, he caught his double jump, so that happens.
Can I recover from that? No down B as well, so, you know, we gotta suffer for now.
Okay, this is the Palutena attacks. Okay, only 21%. And catching! That's a good reverse!
And
I was not expecting that, because I was going to say that Naka was a bit more ahead compared to the first stock. But he did manage to get like caught because of that. That's interesting again. Ryze being only 21% this time. Let's see what happens.
Yep, and so far, I mean, Ryze even now looking for those, you know, overshoots from Naka here. But Naka now obviously getting the message and playing things a bit more clean. 100% and a death kill screen.
They were perfect in their punish game. Like here, Ryze managed to understand that, he tried to get a few things in. Mm. And because he was getting behind, he did one mistake, which was using his double jump.
He wanted to get those reversals, He did get it one time, but then again...
On the other hand, when Palutena saw that, she did manage to push him again outside with, I think it was a down tilt to back here or something.
Not sure.
And then, well, he didn't have any more options. Went for the air dodge and then afterwards got punished because he didn't have anything else.
Out of resources, Even the ZSS can falter in those resource battles.
And when you look at the whole game, this is what happened every time one of them did a mistake. They were very good at punishing the other players. Yeah. So yeah, this is a perfect game. Like, if you want to see a good punish game from both sides, this is a game to look at.
And I really like how you mentioned it, because now in disadvantage, especially in Europe, of course, many tend to come back with hitboxes. You know, you're going to whiff the net, I'm going to give you a hitbox, even a kill. But if you're constantly on that side of the game plan, you might falter sooner or later, because seeing those hitboxes in front of you, you need to spend resources. but then you're not safe. You cannot land safe. And this is where Palutena can certainly punish you to death.
Yeah, exactly. And for now, again, a pretty even game for now. And we just need to find who's going to pick the first stock and how they are going to get like a bit ahead. For now, the game was pretty even in the last game. So I'm expecting it to stay like this for now. We went on to Battlefield, though.
Yeah, we did. And I mean, certainly, this is quite a good stage for ZSS in this regard. But, you know, verticality speaking, Palutena is quite good, too.
Oh,
but he don't need those. Yeah, we gotta use our shield.
Who needs verticality when you have horizontality with this back here? Pretty well. I don't think the DI good on the side of Snaka. I'm not sure. But for now, again, the Palutena attack's going for 40%. Pretty good here, catching the recovery.
Oh, I really like how he's preemptive about his punishes.
Whoa!
Oh, wait, you got over right back here.
I don't think that was expected, but yeah, well, it happened. For now, a phase of 70% and still going in.
Oh my goodness, this is quite a stock here. I mean, he might even lose it earlier than he might expect.
Yeah, Knacka.
Oh, this is a punish, yeah.
Knacka is doing wonders here, and on the side of Ryzer, you see that he did some
panic. Oh my, this is okay. Knacka cracking every defensive option here.
Yeah. And Ryzer is panicking. You've seen this up smash before. Finally patching a very good option here with the Zedair and the back here. Perfectly done from him, but he's still a lot behind now. He's 160% on his last stock, second stock, sorry. And he does have to find a lot of options.
Yeah, and like, now it's a pacing reset because obviously Knacka did have his time to shine, but now Ryzer can be the one moving up. Why he's different, Hami!
This is exactly what he needed to find, and he found it perfect from the side of Ryzer. And yeah, he's ahead now.
Yeah, quite shocking for Knacka as well, because now Knacka has to like just maintain his mental space. Like, this just happened, you have to accept it and move on.
Yeah, and again, they are both having like all the catching all the opportunities they had. Very good catch here by the side of
with
Knacka.
The heat haze showdown as well. I mean, I really love the music now.
No, for real. Like, it's again an even game, and we had a lot of exploded setups that happened, and even with that, it's even.
Okay, guessing the roll correctly, but being not too sure about advantage state here.
they are starting to respect the other a bit more.
Yeah, just wait a bit. It takes a slower turn, but now Knacka being the one turning things up. Again, no resources left. He has to have
And there's nothing else! He's got nothing remaining!
I
can understand him.
Oh, same here again. Just as we mentioned in game one, you want to try to look for those reverses, for those, you know, conversions that you like to call it. But this is just too overambitious here. And Knacka knows how to punish those. He kept calm and just waited for this exact moment. And it all paid off, my man.
It's a shame, because again, he didn't do a lot of mistakes, but the only ones he did were punished accordingly by this. It's a shame, for real.
He wasn't taking it slow from this advantage. Yeah.
Thing is, when he was in the advantage state, we've seen how he managed to find this Zedair confirm into down B, right?
Oh, definitely, yeah.
And he did manage to reverse the whole situation, and like he did manage to catch up to the like he was a bit late before.
Oh, he had such a good.